Hello you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I want to share with you my interview I had with my friend Tiana. We met on Instagram. She's also a green beauty lover. She makes the most gorgeous makeup looks and she is also an astrology expert, even though she doesn't call herself a professional. But she does know a lot about the topic, and since I have no clue whatsoever, I was so interested in her just explaining to me about astrology and more specifically about my birth chart, because I have never had that read to me before. And I was very interested in knowing what traits of my personality and who I am come from, like, the different signs, and that really helped me understand myself a little bit more, and I actually find it quite fascinating. So please enjoy the interview. It was a little bit long, so I think I'm going to split it into two parts just because I want you to get all the information. And at the end, I'm going to share Tiana's Instagram handle, her YouTube channel, and all her info where you can find it, because she truly is like an astrology gem, and I just love talking to her about these kind of things. So please enjoy, and remember, it's gonna be a two-parter, and here we go.
Are you excited to have your chart read?
Yes, I'm very excited because I've never had anything done of this sort. So
okay, so the first thing I want to start with is your ascendant sign. Your ascendant sign is also known as a rising sign. And basically what it represents is, number one, how you appear to people, what your reputation is, and also like your public persona. It might not be like how you feel inside, or it might be, and you might really identify with it. But really it's like what people see about you when they first meet you. Like they can immediately, like the first time they met you, they would describe you in this way.
Okay.
And also it can represent how you look, because different zodiac signs rule different parts of the body. So for Capricorn ascendant, which is what you are, they have a chiseled features. So like very fine, delicate, but chiseled features, which you do. Okay. Deep set eyes, serious eyes. And then also a big head and large teeth with beautiful lips.
Oh my God, no. I don't think my lips are that pretty. But I do have the teeth, I think.
Okay, so that's the physical part of your ascendant. The other part of the ascendant, because you are in Capricorn, means that, for instance, you're going to represent the traits of a Capricorn. You're going to appear to be Capricorn-like to other people. Now, for people who are not familiar, and since you don't know the signs, Capricorns are very serious, ambitious. Sometimes they can appear to be power hungry, but most of the time, no. They're just like very serious. Like they take their reputation very seriously. They take their commitments very seriously. They're known as like the mom dad, like one of the mom dad signs of the zodiac, because they're very responsible and reliable. Right. They also only trust what they have experienced. So like you might be like the super pragmatic realist, hardcore realist of your group, who like everyone else is like, yeah, and you know, she said if I just think about it, then it's gonna happen. You might be the one that's like, no, you have to work hard and put in effort. It's not just going to appear for you. Mm-hmm. Like you might be that kind of person to them, or you might just appear that way, but maybe you don't really think that way. Like maybe you do have a belief in like something else other than, you know, just like putting your nose to the grind. But Capricorn is all about what they can experience. And they're an earth sign, which means they're very grounded. So like everything that they believe about the world is what they have already experienced in the past, what somebody else they know has experienced, and they base everything off of that. That's why they work really hard. And they also tend to be workaholics.
Yeah.
Also, the good thing I noticed here is that since you are a sun Scorpio, you actually have your ascendant and moon are both earth signs, which means that even though you're a water sign, you appear very grounded. You don't appear like out here, your life's not a mess, like, that's kind of like the water sign thing, is that they tend to be like very floaty out there. Not so much like ditzy, like air signs can sometimes appear to be like really ditzy or social. Water signs can be very serious, but like overly emotional. Like some people will say they're too intense, and you have you're grounded by these earth signs, which means that essentially you have like a good sense of realism on top of like however you feel.
Okay.
All right.
Okay. That makes sense.
So sun sign in Scorpio. Sun sign in Scorpio is basically about, like, they're very intense. They're very sometimes serious, but not all the time. They basically just, like, know how they feel, and they're very committed to that. And they trust their intuition, like, 100%. If that's how they feel about it, they're going to go for it. And unlike other signs where they might be like, well, I think this, or like this other person thinks this way, they wouldn't be so influenced by that. They very deeply trust who they are inside. And also, they're mysterious to other people, which it makes them very magnetic and very charismatic, because mm-hmm. other people see them as intense and holding. They don't really like show all of their cards. They're not like social air signs. So basically, the way that you come off to other people is like very mysterious, because you hold all this stuff to your chest. You don't tell people everything, and you don't like blurt it out or like express it all the time, even though like you right. might be feeling 1,000 emotions. Now, also, your sun sign is your ego, or you might really feel that way, but it might not necessarily be true in reality. Right. Okay, so you also have your moon in Virgo. This makes you very logical, but also very pure-hearted. You try to communicate how you feel all the time. You're probably really good at talking about how you feel. And this depends on aspects too, because keep in mind, if you have a different, like if you have your moon aspected by something else, it can suffocate that and you won't express it or feel it as much. So that can sometimes be like why certain people are like, oh, I don't really relate with that. Because sometimes if you have a hard aspect to it, to where it's like not being expressed, then you won't relate to that placement as much, because you don't express it. And the moon can represent your mother and how you right. feel about your mother, how you looked at your mother as being like either very detail oriented, being able to like remember everything. If you get in an emotional mindset, like other people, if they have like a water sign here, they'll get very like emotional and just like not know how to organize their thoughts, but you're mm-hmm. not that person. You might be able to be like, oh, I'm super emotional right now, but also like I remember like last Wednesday at 3 p.m. you did this to me, and like last Thursday, and also last year around fall, I remember because of this, and like remember mm-hmm. all the details of an event that happened more vividly than other people. And other people might be like, what are you talking about? Or yes. you might bring it up in arguments where you're like, yeah, I remember that time you did that, because I remember that you were wearing a green shirt, and you like remember all of these details that other people literally don't remember. And you can communicate so clearly in a way that other people get tripped up, because they're like, how do you even remember that? Like, I don't remember even what happened. Right. Like, and remembering mm-hmm. like the fine details of exactly mm-hmm. what happened, where you were at, like what you even were feeling on that Wednesday.
Right.
And other people just will not remember that at all. And yeah. it actually, you know, it's a really great placement to have. I mean, it can feel like your emotions are hard to express because it's an earth sign and it's not a natural placement, but at the same time, you're good at communicating how you feel logically, meaning that like other people are more easily able to understand you. So you have your Mercury in Libra. Mercury rules communication. Mm-hmm. And so that placement actually, it talks about like how you communicate with other people and how you sort of relate to other people. You have it in Libra, which means that you communicate in a way that is very, it can be people pleasing, meaning that like when you communicate with others, you want to like harmonize with them and be balanced and like understand where they're coming from. You're probably a really understanding person when you talk to other people.
Right.
But also like you want things to be fair and diplomatic, and it's probably fair to say that unless you're like super upset or unless you're really heated, you wouldn't say something that would hurt somebody else, because you would mm-hmm. care about being diplomatic and fair and balanced, and like worried that, you know, if things were unjust, that would be like the thing that would heat you up, like that would make you pissed off at somebody to say something to them. But otherwise you would be like trying to keep like the balance all the time and like not ruffle anybody's feathers. And mm-hmm. the way that you would communicate to them would be very pleasant and nice. Not to say you would sugarcoat, but maybe you would. Like just to save someone's feelings, because like you're like the Libra placement is super caring and they care about what other people think. Okay. You have Venus in Sagittarius. Venus in Sagittarius. So Venus rules friendship and also money and also your romantic relationships. I don't know if the person you're with is a Sagittarius. This is not necessarily the ruling house for love, but sometimes mm-hmm. it can be that. Or if mm-hmm. they have a Venus placement that's compatible with Sagittarius, it would make sense. He's not a Sun Sagittarius. So you would have to look at his Venus placement and see if it's compatible with Sagittarius.
Okay.
But anyway, so Venus, again, rules friendship. So this is how you act in your love life, friendships, and also how you go about making money. But there are other things that influence it. It's a little complicated. I'm trying to keep it simple.
Yeah.
So in your friendships, you might be like super into exploring, going to see new places, trying new stuff, exploring, and like also really like open to trying new things, like with your friends or in a relationship. That might be exact, or you expand in that way, right? Like you really feel more open to go and do things with other people, especially your friends, and if you're in a relationship, to go traveling. Just because Sagittarius is sort of like the wanderlust sign, they're like the ones that want to go and explore and expand and learn everything there is to be in the world.
Okay.
And also, too, they can be the philosophers of, like, one of the philosophers of the zodiac. So you could also really enjoy discussing philosophy and, like, what you believe about the world with your friends. As well as, you know, when you're in a relationship, you could be very exploratory, like, going to new places, trying new things with them, or, like, sexually.
Okay.
We'll move on.
Real fast. Okay.